Bacteria are the oldest inhabitants of Earth, and you can find them literally everywhere. Most are beneficial or harmless, but some can cause infections. Fortunately, antibiotics allowed us to control harmful bacteria, making surgical interventions possible and healing previously dangerous diseases. However, antibiotics are becoming less effective lately due to the rise of antibiotic resistance. Bacterial success as colonizers relies on their incredible adaptability and their huge numbers. Mutations, which are changes in the DNA code, occur spontaneously at a very low frequency, but large bacterial populations likely include individuals carrying mutations. Most mutations are deleterious or neutral for the bacterium, but some might be beneficial in certain conditions. In antibiotic-rich environments, such as our societies, mutations conferring resistance provide a big advantage. Moreover, mutation is not the only way to acquire resistance. Bacteria themselves produce antibiotics and thus often carry genes encoding resistance proteins to protect them from their own antibiotics. Furthermore, resistance can be transferred from bacterium to bacterium, favoring the spread of resistance. Antibiotics target proteins involved in processes essential for bacterial physiology, and resistance mutations often land in the genes encoding these proteins, disturbing their normal function, therefore causing problems to the bacterial cell. Thus, when the antibiotic is absent, most resistance mutations actually slow down the growth of resistant bacteria. This negative effect is called the fitness cost of resistance and is important to us because if, for instance, a few susceptible bacteria survive an antibiotic treatment, the cost allows them to outcompete resistant bacteria once the treatment is over. Lowering antibiotic usage would decrease the advantage of resistant bacteria. Unfortunately, it does not completely prevent the spread of resistance because of an evolutionary phenomenon called compensation. Compensation occurs when the resistant bacteria acquires additional mutations that alleviate the cost of resistance, allowing resistant bacteria to grow efficiently both in the presence and absence of antibiotic. Moreover, there are interactions between resistance mutations where one compensates for the cost of the other. Talk about bad luck. Scientists studying antibiotic resistance know, however, that the cost and the compensation of resistance depend on the environment where bacteria grow. Traditionally, the costs have been measured mostly in laboratory conditions, but scientists are now starting to measure them in animal models, more similar to clinically relevant environments, to quantify the real costs of each resistance. Antibiotic resistance is a very serious problem, but don't get pessimistic. Research and health institutions, such as WHO, ERC, NIH, and others, have made a top priority reducing antibiotic resistance. At this moment, thousands of scientists around the world are working hard to stop resistance dissemination by investigating solutions and alternatives to antibiotics, such as phage therapy, antivirulence drugs, novel vaccines, and more. Additionally, novel policies to limit the misuse of antibiotics are being implemented. Here are some things you can do to help. First, it's important to use antibiotics correctly. Antibiotics should be a last resort, reserved only for bacterial infections that our organism is not capable of fighting on its own, and never for viral infections, because antibiotics only kill bacteria, not viruses. Second, if you really need antibiotics, make sure you take them exactly as the doctor prescribed, at the dose, and for the number of days recommended. And of course, washing your hands, using soap, and getting vaccinated helps a lot. By preventing infections, you avoid the need for antibiotics in the first place. Let's resist resistance together.